thing is that there is a change also in the way people from the left, meaning trade unions, social movements, or political parties, are debating about Europe is something different of the debates we had some years ago. Let me explain myself. For years, during the economic crisis, we were debating inside the left about if it was good to exit the European Union or to be inside the European Union and reform the treaties from inside. I mean that all the debate was around the European Union as a political architecture, as a political structure. Yes, of course it is. But one of the things I personally discovered that from 1 year and a half or the last year is that there is a different debate arising, which is how, let me say like that, how capitalism is changing the way of the power is organizing Europe itself. Meaning that the European Union was based on a division of power in South Europe, based also in the nation state, mostly France and Germany, and the power of those countries. And one of the, I think, more of the most important characteristic of this post-democracy we are living, like it was said before, is that the way capitalism is accumulation profits is changing the reproduction system and also the political powers that represent them. Let me explain you in a map, no? It's like, actually the economic power in Europe is in, of course, it's in Germany, in England, just a little, or Denmark, not so much in France. And the south of Europe, we are completely outside the circuit of capital accumulation. We are outside the project of the elite that is not more related in how the European Union constructor as a political structure, but how capitalism itself is working and reorganizing Europe in that way. Why I say that? Because I came from Spain. We know in Spain that we are the south, we are in the periphery, that we are a country which is not the biggest country taking decisions in Europe because we are weak in terms of economic. Somebody has decided that my country has to have no industry anymore, has to be a country only for low salaries, bad jobs, precariousness, and tourism as the only industry in the country. And this was a political decision. It's nothing that came up out of the blue of because of the economic is that way. No, it was a decision made. Of course, the south of Italy, the same, and Portugal. Why our politics are, decreasing industry? There is no public investment in any industry. In any industry is amazing. And this contradiction generating something that is a contradiction that I really like. I love contradiction, but which is that while the economic power today in Europe is in the central northern countries, the left is stronger in the south. It's stronger in Greece, in Spain, in Portugal, and I hope in Italy soon. And it's logical, because there is a reaction about the situation. And how this reaction against the situation can change Europe also. That is the change I'm proposing you to think about. And it was not the former debates about how the European Union has to be built. No, it's a different situation, in which I think in the south of Europe, we have the historical task of spreading a new view of Europe, basing on the non-exploitation of human beings, and the, you know what I mean? I mean, a Europe based really in a different perspective than the capitalism is creating. That's the reason why I do believe in a diverse Europe. Our proposal for Europe cannot be homogenic or unique. No, that's wrong thing. Because one of our most beautiful values is diversity. Not only cultural, but also in terms of economics. So it's very difficult to make one only proposal for the whole Europe because the diversity is really very strong. I mean, I'm seeing my comedy from Portugal, it's nothing related to what's happening in Sweden, believe me. It's another world. The south in Portugal is another world, or the south of Spain. So, but we can share a dream of building in our continent a completely different structure of what the capitalism is trying to impose. And also, and this is the second contradiction, which, as I said, I love contradictions, which I see, which is really interesting also, we talked about this before talking about feminism, which is, if one of the most terrible things we are suffering in Europe, and especially in the south of Europe, is the precariousness as a, no, the way capitalism has made precariousness as a normal thing. It's not a scandalous anymore to earn 500 euros per month. It's not a scandalous. It's this is amazing how quick, yeah, that they impose the people that is normal to have those conditions of exploitation. Okay, so during the last century, we left the labor questions to the trade unions. So if we want to improve the conditions of labor, we said, okay, let us make the trade unions stronger, because the trade union task is to do so. And I think that the level of precariousness is so high in our society, so transversal, that we cannot leave only the trade union the task of changing the precariousness and the quality of job, which is the how can we deliver a better life for our people. And it's something that is in the feminism understood perfectly well. When it's talk about strikes, when it's talk about reproduction and productive work, and it's something that I think we have to learn from the feminists also, and to not only to leave to the trade union the question of the precariousness. So my last remark is only that, as always, there is no magical recipe for this situation, but it's something that always works, and it is to build alliances. Build all alliances possible against austerity, and to share the idea with people, trade unions, organizations, whoever wants to talk and to build a different perspective and a different dream for our beautiful continent. Thank you.
Grazie, Marga. Siete splendidi, rispettate proprio i tempi. Massimo Tanelli, che è coordinatore dell'Alta Europa Consiglio.